What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com, and this is the first tutorial in Python Pandas series. It is the introduction to Python Pandas. I highly suggest you to watch this video till the end because the terminology that we will be discussing here is going to be used throughout the series. So without wasting much of your time, I'm going to give you a quick yet informative introduction to the most powerful library of Python programming. So let's start. Python Pandas is an open source library for data analysis. Since it's open source, thus it's available to all of us for free. Using Python Pandas, you can work with rectangular data very easily. So, what is rectangular data? Nothing. It's just a fancy name given to the data that is stored in row and column format. You must have come across such data if you have ever worked with a relational database. Some people also refer to rectangular data as a spreadsheet-like data, because data in a spreadsheet, like MS Excel, also happen to be saved in row-column fashion, hence the name spreadsheet-like data. Anyways, let's come to the topic. Using Pandas, you can not only load the data in fast and efficient manners, but also manipulate it according to the need of your data analysis project. To do this, Python Pandas introduced two new data types. Let's talk about them in detail. The two new data types that Python Pandas introduced are data frame and series. In layman language, a data frame can be thought of as an entire spreadsheet, whereas a series refers to a single column of that spreadsheet. Some books refer to data frame as a 2D labeled data structure and a series as a 1D labeled data structure similar to 1D array. Calling them a data structure is completely justifiable. See, a data structure is a way to store and organize data to facilitate access and modification. A data structure is defined as a way of storing and organizing the data in such a way that it is easily available for modification and further processing. In Pandas, we use data frame and series for storing the data. Hence, they are referred to as data structure. Since series is a 1D array-like data structure, thus it can hold the data of similar data types only, which also makes it a homogeneous one-dimensional data structure. But unlike series, a data frame can hold the data of different data types. Thus we can say that a data frame is a heterogeneous two-dimensional data structure. In simple words, in a data frame, a column must contain the data of similar data type, whereas a row can contain a data of different data types. For example, here we have a data frame that contains the data of employees. As you can see, this data frame has three columns: name, age, and date of joining. The data type of the first column, name, is a string, or in Pandas language, object. The data type of the second column, age, is integer. And the data type of the last column, date of joining, is date. Each of these columns are holding the data of their respective data types. And if you will look at the data in each of these rows, you will find that they are of different data types. Hope this cleared all your doubt. If you like this video, then please press the thumbs up button. Also, share it with your friends. That being said, now let's move ahead. But technically, Python is an object-oriented programming language, which means whatever you create and use in Python is a class. That implies Pandas data frame and series is nothing but a class which has their own attributes and methods. And similar to every other class, to use these attributes and methods, we need to create an instance of these classes. We will learn how to do that in the next video. So subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, don't forget to press that bell icon. Anyways, before we wrap up this Python Pandas tutorial, here is a quick fact. Did you know that the Python Pandas has its own data type? The data type of the data that is stored in a data frame is not the same as those that comes with the Python standard library. For example, in Python Pandas, the data type of the string type data is object, and the data type of integer type data is int 64, and the float type data is stored as float 64, whereas date type data is stored as date times 64. Comment yes if you already knew that. I guess that's enough for this introduction to the Python pandas. In the next tutorial, we will be writing some code. So subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We'll see you soon. Till then, take care. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.